This project came on the table, I guess, 2 years ago, when the idea was to do a big body of work about child mothers, girls up to 15 years of age, giving birth to a child. We have been working in 7 different countries in the world. We photographed, interviewed 26 girls. And everywhere we came, we built up the studio. It's a big piece of cloth, which you have to build up in, say, in a desert or in the countryside in Zambia. It blows and the sun is maybe not correct. So it's quite a challenge as well to make everything work in that way, logistically. The idea behind the photo studio was to create a special place for these young girls because they don't have any family. Many of them don't have a boyfriend anymore. The father of the child is maybe not playing an active role in the girl's life. But wherever you travel around the world, people always love to take the photograph in a professional studio. So I wanted to create basically a feeling for these girls that they were taking their family portrait. We could build up the studio in the middle of a street, somewhere. Sometimes hundreds of people would gather around the studio, but everyone was very, very quiet because in some kind of way they realized that they want this photo to be good as well. So all the neighbors, everyone would be there. And did this official studio moment.
It's a huge problem with girls below the age of 15 giving birth to children. And no one really knows how many these girls are. UN estimates that there are around 2 million girls every year below the age of 15 who give birth to children. That equals more than 5,000 girls per day that become mothers. In this project, a lot of the things that we have touched is the shattered dreams of children, actually. Because all these girls that we have interviewed had dreams before they got pregnant or before they got married. They didn't choose to become mothers. They had plans of, you know, becoming teachers or journalists or architects, you know. But then this happens because of lack of knowledge, lack of services, lack of freedom for them to choose. It's an eye-opener for many people when they see the images and they hear the stories.
One of the biggest problems I noticed was that so many of these girls were not able to talk about this in their own environment. And when we did the longer interviews, we realized that all of a sudden, these girls were talking about this for the first time in their lives, about feelings and about how it is to take care of a child and how it is to become pregnant and how their environment reacts on it as well. And that gives me, though, when I think back on it, a sad feeling within me then that they're very alone as well in this process. And also you realize how important childhood is when you see these children becoming mothers. Then all of a sudden childhood is gone. There is no knowledge almost about sexuality. They might have sexual education, but it is a late stage of their teens. And that's, of course, insane, because when a girl turns 12 or 13, she will be able to get pregnant. And it's just shocking to realize that sexual education is taboo.
The aim of the Child Mothers Initiative is to raise awareness of the issue of children having children. First of all, to make the leaders of the world acknowledge these girls, that these girls exist. And then, of course, we want action. We want resources dedicated to prevent girls from becoming pregnant. So we want to see more resources towards sexuality education in school, towards youth-friendly services for all children at all ages. Most of the time, they are expelled once they become pregnant. So we also want support for these girls to get back into school.
To produce a project like this, the more you work with it, the more knowledge you get, the more you realize how much more action we need to take around the world. We need to put pressure on a lot of countries. Standing here today, the UN in Geneva, it's so important because we know, we've seen in the field, how bad it can be, how important it is that we come to a place like this where people are having their representatives, where people are making decisions. That's all about that. We need to make people aware how serious this problem is in the world.